Some of them landed in the port. Many landed in the city. Life in Antwerp was transformed. Each bomb killed or wounded an average of 38 people. Old women, accustomed to a round of housekeeping and shopping, were suddenly crushed under tons of debris. The lives of children playing in the streets were violently interrupted. Homes became a ghostly setting for those who escaped death. Antwerp, its port and its people would have been wiped off the earth were it not for the defense system known as Antwerp X. The story of Antwerp X began before the bombs came. Allied intelligence knew that the Germans had been building launching sites east and southeast of Antwerp. Counter preparations had been made. Under General Clare Armstrong, a combined organization of American, British, and Polish gunners were assigned to the defense of the city. It was their job to defend the city against the V-1. Against the V-2, which traveled too fast to be seen, there was no defense. We knew that the German attack could come from many directions. Our strategy was one of shifting defenses. When the V-1s began to come over from one direction, batteries would be shifted quickly, so that several belts of anti-aircraft fire, one behind the other, could protect the city. To make this strategy a success, new lines of attack had to be expected, and anti-aircraft units had to move quickly from one position to another. The gun crews around Antwerp learned to meet the extraordinary demands made by their jobs. A move order was just a couple of points on a map, but to the men it meant something more, something vital and urgent. They had seen the damage and death that the V-1s could bring. They knew that lives in Antwerp were at stake. They learned the importance of moving quickly. At all hours of the day and night, the small towns of Belgium shuddered as heavy equipment rushed along the quiet streets on the way to new positions of defense. The men got to know their jobs so thoroughly that handling the guns became second nature to them. It was like walking or talking. It seemed they had done it always. They learned speed in setting up, speed in getting the word through, speed in firing. They learned accuracy. When the bombs first came, our gunners shot down only one out of every two bombs. Before the shooting was over, they were bringing down better than 9 out of 10. It wasn't the gunners alone. At each step in the process of bringing down a bomb, there were men whose place in Antwerp X was vital. Observers moved far forward into frontline positions to spot the V-1s soon after the takeoff from Germany. From these forward outposts, they flashed the earliest warning of an approaching bomb. Back at the battery, the signal comes in, and the gunners go to work. In a matter of seconds, each man is at his post, doing the job upon which all Antwerp was depending. A job of cooperation, a team of American and British troops blending its efforts. Through rapid estimations, the course of the bomb was plotted. Plotting was based on information received by radar units. Antennas scan the skies, listening, feeling, searching to discover the course of the bomb as exactly as possible. The bomb comes into range of the gun battery. And now the gun crews have their target. When one belt of guns failed to bring down a V-1, there was at least one other battery backing up the first. Sometimes four and five belts of guns guarded the bomb lanes to Antwerp. For 160 days, the men of Antwerp X were on duty every day. And there were few nights when a man could get continuous sleep. Sooner or later, there came an ominous sound in the night,